Again, welcome to English Literature class, students. Now I'm going to start the speech of Bassanio. Open your book, please, and see here. In Belmont is a lady richly left. When Antonio asked, "Who was that lady? Tell me about that lady." To whom you want to meet secretly, Bassanio says, in Belmont is a lady richly left, and she is fair and fairer than that word. He says, in Belmont there is a lady who has inherited much wealth, who has so much wealth got from her father. She is beautiful, he says, she is fair and fairer than that word. She is beautiful and has great virtues, qualities. She is a virtuous lady. Sometimes from her eyes I did receive fair speechless messages. He says, sometimes I have received from her eyes lovely silent messages. Her name is Portia, nothing undervalued. To Cato's daughter, Brutus Portia. He says, her name is Portia and she is no less precious than Cato's daughter, who was the wife of Brutus. Here, Portia here is compared to Portia in Julius Caesar, who was a daughter of Cato and wife of Brutus, a brave Roman general, the leader of the conspiracy against Julius Caesar. Nor is the wide world ignorant of her worth. He says, her name is Portia and she is no less precious than Cato's daughter, and who was the wife of Brutus. Indeed, the whole world is aware of her worth. Of her worth, of her values, of her wealth, etc. For famous suitors are sailing towards her from every coast. He says, what is the reason? As she is virtuous, she is wealthy, she has inherited much wealth. So, for the four winds blow in from every coast, renowned suitors, and her sunny locks hang on her temples like a golden fleece. He says here, for famous suitors, who are the, indeed the whole world is aware of her worth. For famous suitors are sailing towards her from every coast, from every nook and corner of the world. Her pretty hair adorns her forehead. Her pretty hair adorns her forehead, this one, like the golden fleece. Like the golden fleece. Then he says, which makes her seat a Belmont, Colchos strand, and many Jasons come in quest of her. He says, Bassanio says to Antonio that so that her home at Belmont is like the ancient kingdom of Colchos. So many people, so many suitors, rather than you can say, come here to marry her. Many suitors like Jasons go there to win her. Oh Antonio, he says, oh my Antonio, had I but the means to hold a rival place with one of them, I have a mind presages me such thrift that I should questionless be fortunate. He says here, oh Antonio, had I the money, I have no money, had I the money, if I had the money to compete with those suitors, those who are coming from coast, from all coasts, my instinct tell me that I should surely be the winner. I am sure my conscience tells me that I should surely be the winner if I had the money. He says, here Antonio's speech, thou knowest that all my fortunes are at sea, neither have I money nor commodity to raise a present sum. Therefore, go forth. Try what my credit can in Venice do that shall be racked even to the uttermost to furnish thee to Belmont, to fair Portia. Antonio says, you know that all my money is invested in my ships at sea. All my money is invested in my ships at sea. I have neither cash nor anything on which money could be raised. But go out and see what my credit can do in Venice. It shall be stretched to the utmost limit to enable you to go to Belmont and win over the beautiful Portia. Go at once and inquire, and I shall do the same. Says, go presently inquire, and so will I, where money is, and I no question make to have it of my trust or for my sake. He says, go at once and inquire, and I shall do the same. I will also inquire wherever money could be had, could be get. And I have no doubt that I shall have it. As he is very renowned merchant, he is very famous, very renowned. People of Venice gives honor, give honor, his very reputed person. So he says, I no doubt that I shall have it, I shall have the money, either on account of my business, either on account of my business or against my personal surety. I shall have the money, I shall have it, either on account of my business credit or against my personal surety. They leave means Antonio and Bassanio both leave from there, and that is the end of Act 1, Scene 1. Still, if you have any problem, please ask me. I am always ready to help you. Thank you so much.